Tomorrow morning, 10 a.m. to 12, we've got Congressman Jason Altmaier here. Now, we're getting reports that he could be coming down as a no. Increasing reports, I'm getting these from a variety of sources, who say that the Blue Dog Democrat, despite meeting one-on-one with President Obama this week, is going to be voting against this, part of an August team that we have tomorrow.
Welcome to the Glenn Beck Program. Tonight, we were going to do our Ask Glenn Anything show, but instead, I'm going to do some of the asking. I'm asking members of Congress and the American people, where do we go from here? There is a ticking time bomb, a fundamental transformation of our country. A lot of work to do. Where do we head from here? Come on, let's find out. It is Friday, but it is a big, big weekend that we're headed for. The health care vote is happening this Sunday. At least that's what they tell us so far. And the process that the president doesn't seem to care about has been so abused, the average person in America has absolutely no idea what is even happening. What has happened to our country? Is there no honor anymore? The Sunday vote, which I find absolutely amazing that we're creating rights on the Sabbath, how about a final slap in the face to God? The Sunday vote would make changes to the Senate-passed bill while deeming the original legislation to have passed the House. Yeah, let's forget about that whole Constitution thing where it has to pass both the House and the Senate. You know, no. Let's instead just deem that it has been passed in the House. Do congressional members really think that America will forget, or are they counting on big labor just to pull them through? Congress doesn't seem to mind the fact that their Gallup poll shows their approval rating is the lowest ever, 16%. When your approval rating is that low, I have news for you. That's when people become dangerous because they'll go out in a blaze of glory. And I think that's what a lot of people in Washington are doing. They don't care that 73% of America don't want this bill. They will be in the history books. Why are they pushing? Well, it's not all of the Democrats. Remember, none of the Republicans are voting for this. The Republicans aren't stalling this. Only the Democrats are stalling on this. It is the progressives going after the blue dog or moderate Democrats. This will be the final snuff out of any kind of moderate Democratic movement. The radicals are the ones that want this. It is a pathway to a single-payer system. Last night, Jon Stewart did about a 15-minute segment making fun of me, and I have to tell you, that was hysterical. He was very, very funny, but he continues to get it wrong. He should really kind of watch this show once in a while. He is he's saying that I'm crazy and all of this kind of stuff, but he's missing the point. Jon, where am I wrong exactly? Nancy Pelosi said, quote, "We won that fight, and once through this door, we will kick it open. There will be more legislation to follow." This really kind of goes from something that I said that I had been called crazy for last year. Remember, the White House came out and said I was spreading disinformation because what I was saying was coming was universal health care, that they were going to cripple and control the insurance companies until they were no longer in business. We were going to have a Canadian health care system. Well, no, no, no. Glenn Beck's crazy. He's got that wrong. Well, Nancy Pelosi, what is this? How about Tom Harkin when he said this?
As I've said before, this bill is not complete. I've used the analogy of a starter home, in which we can add additions and enhancements as we go into the future. But like every right that we've ever passed for the American people, we revisit it later on to enhance and build on those rights.
Stop. Now
and
remember, everybody has been saying for a long time, I'm crazy, I have it wrong, don't listen to Glenn Beck, right? You know this, the Tea Partiers have known this. There is a hidden agenda. Listen to what Joe Biden has said now about, no, 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 you'll be able to have your insurance companies. No, we're not going to hassle the insurance company. Here's the latest from Joe Biden on insurance companies.
Some of them, I say, they say, well, Joe, look, man, I mean, you know, you guys haven't messaged this very well. And, you know, this thing has gone on so long, and I don't know. And my response is, hey, man, the proof of the pudding is in the eating. I'm telling you, you know, pre-existing, they're going to be covered. You know we're going to control the insurance companies.
You know we're going to control the insurance companies. Not only was this program and the Tea Partiers right, These people now say this was their plan the whole time. Watch this.
Because the rules say that because of some of the rules about reconciliation, that you actually have to include the student aid bill with the health care bill. This was the plan all along. When the budget came out for 2010, instructions were given for reconciliation for both health care and for student loans.
Instructions were given. The video is from the Center for American Progress, George Soros. We were right. They, the group in Washington and all of their little minions, have clearly been lying about this bill and discrediting anyone that was exposing it. They were just trying to cloud the facts.
But we have to pass the bill so that you can find out what is in it away from the fog of the controversy.
Away from the fog of controversy. Who's been creating the fog? What about when the president said this week in one of the most important interviews this president has ever given? Thank God for Bret Baier. Listen to what the president said this week to Bret Baier.
Now, you keep on repeating the notion that it's one-sixth of the economy. Yes, it's one-sixth of the economy, but we're not transforming one-sixth of the economy all in one fell swoop.
It's going to transform. It will slowly be transformed. How do I know that? Because this is what the president said. Now, remember, the president has been saying in the last year, I'm not for a single-payer health care plan. I'm not for it. But do you hear what he's saying here? We're going to slowly go into it. Let's compare this week's statement with Bret Baier with what he said in 2007. New video.
My belief that not just politically, but also economically, it's better for us to start getting a system in place, a universal health care system, signed into law by the end of my first term as president, and build off that system to make it more rational.
More rational.
By the way, Canada did not start off immediately with a single-payer system. They had a similar transition step.
Transitioning a system is a very difficult and costly and lengthy enterprise. It's not like you can turn on a switch and you go from one system to another.
In this same clip, he starts with saying it's at least a $2 trillion program. Thank you, but no thank you. We have been lied to, and you see now, I'll show you later on in the program, they're now using water as a wedge. Water as a bribe. Holy cow, we are in bed with some really evildoers. Oh boy, did that sound like George Bush? We know what's coming. We know what's coming. With me now, former Pennsylvania Senator and Fox News contributor Rick Santorum and Massachusetts Treasurer Tim Cahill, who is now running for governor in Massachusetts. You were a Democrat.
Yes.
Correct? And you've just become an independent.
Last summer.
Okay, and I want to make this clear. I don't know anything really about you, but do you ever watch this show?
I have, yes.
Do we agree on very much?
Sometimes, yeah.
Sometimes, okay.
Yeah.
But probably more principles than policies, I'm guessing.
It depends.
Okay.
It depends.
You want reform on health care.
Correct.
So do I. I just don't want the government to do it. I want the government to ease restrictions, et cetera, et cetera. Do you want a big program?
No.
Okay.
No.
You say, now you're the Secretary of Treasury.
I'm the
right?
Treasurer,
yeah,
yes.
You're the Treasurer. You say that if this passes, this will bankrupt the United States within 4 years.
Based on our experience in Massachusetts.
Tell me, compare. A, B, compare.
Well, we have what David Axelrod referred to as the pilot program. It was started 4 years ago in Massachusetts. Universal health care, to mandate to cover everyone in the state of Massachusetts. It wasn't going to cost us a whole lot of money, so they said. It was going to work. We have a public exchange that was going to match up private insurance with people who couldn't get insurance or small businesses. Hasn't worked out the way they said it was going to work out. And it has increased costs just in Massachusetts of about $4 billion over when this program was started in 2006. And just today, the governor himself announces an extra $300 million hole in our health care line items. So it is bankrupting the state and would have bankrupted our state if not for the federal government being overly generous with Medicaid reimbursements over these last 4 years. They've really propped this system up to keep it in place.